extremely pleased to be here at Consulate General of India, New York, and I am grateful to them for giving me an opportunity to participate on a seminar on insolvency and bankruptcy code. As you all know, it is one of the very deep economic reforms the country has embarked on, and it has been implemented with unprecedented pace. There is no parallel either in India or elsewhere such swift implementation. And this has also been recognized by the World Bank in its ease of doing business. In fact, India for the year 2018 got the most improved jurisdiction award from Global Restructuring Review, United Kingdom. Thank you.
It's a real pleasure to be here in New York at our consulate. We are doing a series of events related to talking about insolvency and bankruptcy code and the distressed asset market, inviting investors from around the world to come and participate in it. Of course, the consulate here has been a great host. They brought in some of the top investors in the world in this space, and we are very pleased to see that we had very fruitful conversations with the investors, and of course we more widely met with portfolio investors as well. So it is a real pleasure to be here in New York, and look forward to being here again. Thank you.
This code, which was introduced in 2016, has been a game changer for assets which were distressed, banks which were facing the problem of non-performing assets. A number of companies have gone through the process and have resolved their insolvency issues.
So today's event on the bankruptcy code, which is organized by the Indian Consulate, is a real signature event, because so far we have been trying to develop this institutional framework in India to handle the NPLs problem. One that as a representative of the largest bank in India, SBI, I get asked about this all the time. About NPLs, how do you resolve them? And this is a real, real good tool, which is still a work in progress, but it's showing initial good results. And this conference today will give investors an idea as to what is going on, the latest thinking. The head of IBBI himself is there, the government representatives are there, the FM addressed us. So it's a real, real good conference. And hopefully it will lead to a lot of more awareness, and people will take more interest into coming into Indian distressed assets.
I think given that India is such a great opportunity, about which the finance minister also spoke this morning, I think it would be a great idea for any of the foreign investors to really come, look at these stressed assets and start engaging in this process in the country. So this is the reason why we did this event at the council.
For the first time in India's independent history, it's created a modern market-based framework for stressed assets. There's a great deal of interest with the investors in the United States in Indian markets and Indian markets for stressed, distressed, and bankrupt assets. A lot of private equity firms, hedge funds, debt investors are moving in that direction. The capital flows are increasing. India is hungry for capital at this stage of its development, and it's a good sign that finally this has happened.